Hi all, and welcome to an extra edition this week of the Truth, Honor and Integrity Show. My name's Thomas Williams, and today is February the 2nd. Now, following the announcement yesterday of America being declared sovereign, obviously there was many questions that needed to be asked and answered. And so we have another show, and this is a follow-up to last night's historic announcement of America being declared a sovereign nation. And the show will be in three parts. It will be supplemented with music, as we often do with our shows. And part one will be some background and some real history. That may be a shocker to some. Part two will be the reading of the announcement again. And part three will be the implications of it. I hope you enjoy the show.
The NSA, in God we trust, or the
Hi all, and welcome to the Truth, Honour and Integrity Show. My name's Thomas Williams, and we've got an extra show this evening. Normally we do Thursday nights only, but given the announcement last night and the various questions that comes up, I thought I would do a follow-up show, so it then is more focused on what that entails. So, I hope you enjoy the show, and I hope you spread it far and wide, because it's up to us to push it, and hopefully for a speedy and smooth transition from being a colony country to a sovereign country. Now, for the first part, for those who don't listen to our show regularly, you will be shocked at much we in America have been allowed to, right from day one. Our history and our knowledge base of the real history is a far cry from what you have been taught. So how did we get here? Well, many of you will be confused, thinking America is already free. We declared independence back in 1776. Except that is the first major falsehood that led us to this week. The reality is, most of our history in this country has been built on a pack of lies and half-truths, and in this piece you'll find out some of the depth of it. The Declaration of Independence was largely delivered and signed by either British or acting on behalf of British Freemasons under a banner known as the Crown. So the Founding Fathers, who are much revered in this country, were actually British Crown agents. Now, many presume the Crown is connected to the British royals. It is not. The Crown, which is based in a square mile in London, the United Kingdom, known as the Temple Bar, is entered by invite only, and the Queen actually requires permission to enter that region. Now, the Crown and its region, also known as the City of London, is not affiliated to England, Britain or the UK, but is a separate principality that has its own rules and its own regulations and statutes and all that stuff, being Temple Bar, bar for a reason, and also it doesn't pay taxes. There are other regions similar to this, with the principalities known as the District of Columbia or Washington DC, Vatican City, Luxembourg and Switzerland also enjoy this special status they created for themselves. Now, the staged event, and that's what it was, of the Declaration of Independence and America was free on July the 4th, which is actually a ritual day for those unaware, and you can research that yourself. And yet on the July the 18th and the 19th of the same month, 1776, America received its new tax tariff from Britain. So if we are free, why would we continue to pay taxes to a foreign country? Clearly, we were not free. But if you repeat the lie long enough, people take it as fact. It's not. The War of 1812 is another lie and another staged event, all about slavery and some other nonsense. But a key fact missing in the narrative was Jefferson wanted to attack and claim Canada as part of North America. Well, Canada also comes under the banner of the Commonwealth and the Crown, same as the 13 colonies originally in America. So lots of lives were lost over what was basically, initially at least, over shipping lanes and rights. So allegedly America declared itself free again, except it wasn't, and nothing had really changed. In 1861, which is a key date in American history, we had more shenanigans involving American politics and politicians and legal law sharks operating, as all lawyers do, on behalf of the Crown. For those who don't know, all lawyers are committing treason by operating under a license for the bar, which means British Accreditation Registry. This would become illegal under the original organic constitution, but those sharks cancelled that also in 1861. So we lost the constitution. America has not had its original constitution since that date, and I know this upsets many, but it is the truth. Currently, there are four constitutions in operation, but organic is not being administered. The legalese people are fond of what is known as word magic, whereby they change the title of the piece by changing the font size, lowercasing and capital letters and reversing it, which subtly change the whole meaning of the document. For example, the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution for. It may not seem much, but in reality, it changes everything. The same applies to the states. Is it Florida State or is it the state of Florida? Again, it looks similar, but it's vastly different in the interpretation of the rules. So we've had no real constitution since 1861. Also in 1861 was the last official American government. Since then, we have had a corporation known as the USA Inc. operating or pretending to be our government. It is not. In 1864, the previous incumbents of the World Trust acquired vast tracts of land of America, including what is now known as the District of Columbia, where their takeover of America in its entirety was then formulated to include not just the original 13 colonies, but the rest of the estates being formed or already formed. Then came 1912, which a corporation was formed almost 1 year after the people who were going to vote against it were deliberately sank in the accident of the ship known as the Titanic. It was actually the sister ship called the Olympic, not the Titanic, which had not been renovated. That corporation is now known as the Federal Reserve, who, for those who don't know, this is not our national bank. It is nothing to do with America or its people. One of the Rothschilds, Spitt, famously quoted, "Give me charge of a nation's finances, and I care not who makes the rules." And this is what took place, though that family took over Britain the same way. Well, with the Federal Reserve in place and assisted by treasonous quislings in Congress who sold out the people, the country, and set a course to loot the whole country of its wealth. Of course, almost immediately after the forming of the Federal Reserve, we were thrown into a world war, World War One. You have to understand how they think. War to them means profits for banks. And why this world has been in perpetual war since. Plus, as an added bonus for these psychopaths, it gets rid of some of the useless eaters, as they call us. Touche, parasites. In 1923, the official US Treasury was erased, and various corporations with similar names were created and subjugated the real Treasury. Then they crashed the country, and the economy led in us into a Great Depression, where more legal sharks came in and then declared all Americans as their property and put us up as collateral for the Federal Reserve debts, not our debt. In 1933, they also declared the Emergency War Powers Act, which put us under martial law and rendered the militia irrelevant. They then threw us into another war, which was all about looting ancient gold in Asia, so they wouldn't have to pay back the loans received from them in the form of gold bonds in 1933. For those who don't know, by putting us, we the people, up as collateral, it meant they should have paid all our living expenses. They didn't, obviously. Oops. Instead, they went one, two, and three steps further. In 1934, they stiffed the public again. Not only did they force the public to hand over all their gold and precious metals for a pittance in return, the hijackers then created a temporary measure, well, they said it was temporary at the time, to get America out of debt and back on its knees. Yeah, right. 84 years is not temporary. So what was that? Income tax on your wages. Now, this is illegal. To have taxes on your wages is illegal under the original Constitution. But we're not part of that, are we? It is illegal as wages are not capital gains and so is not subject to tax. In came the next bogus entity to enforce the taxes, known as the IRS. Again, this is a corporation. Well, actually, it's a trust that is not part of America. In fact, it's not even domiciled in America, but is in Puerto Rico. It is a Puerto Rican trust and is the collection arm of the Federal Reserve that collects taxes not for America, but for the Crown. Oops. 67% of our income tax goes to the Crown of England. 23% goes to Federal Reserve shareholders, who are all Crown members. And 10% is operating costs. And how much do the American people get? Zip. 0 cents. Now, when the USA Inc. government, which is what we think is the government, it's actually a corporation called the USA Inc., which is registered in Delaware. You can go and check it up. The USA Inc. government then runs low on funds, which we've all witnessed in the last 10 years, which is deliberately created every year, so we go low on funds. Why? Because then the government has to borrow funds from the Federal Reserve at 6% interest. When in reality, the Federal Reserve already had our money via the wrongly named title of income tax. Your income tax, as it is called, has no reference as a tax in the IRS tax code manual. None. Why? Because it's not a tax at all. It is actually a tribute to the Crown. And as declared in 2013 by the CEO of the IRS in a House session, income tax is also voluntary. And yet it's enforced. Following World War II, in came other corporations like the World Bank, the IMF, who collects social security payments via your chattel number, known as national insurance in the UK and Canada, and social security in America on behalf of the Vatican. The head of the pyramid of the Triangle of Three. Because the Vatican, according to them anyway, they own every person on the planet. Or so they think, anyway. In came, around the same time, the UN. The Bretton Woods agreements. More banking theft, all of which they think they own America, the country, its land, and all its people and the resources. If you think that's not enough, you can add the American flag. It's a British designed and is red, white and blue, the same as the Union Jack. State of the Union indeed. Which Union? It's clearly not ours. The gold fringe around the flag means it's a military flag in a state of perpetual war, and also signifies we are under maritime law, which means it is British law. So the flag is British law. The anthem was written by a Brit as well and adopted by the British agents here operating as Americans. Now, all of these facts can be verified yourselves by a simple search. I'm not taking my word for it, but you'll find it's all correct. Our history, sadly, is bogus. We have no constitution. We have no independence. We have no American bank or tax office. We have no American flag or anthem. We have no American government or military, and had no American president in our lifetimes. That position is a CEO position for the corporation known as the USA Inc. Nothing to do with us. Until now. And it's up to us all to see it properly administered and delivered to the people in a speedy and smooth manner. We're going to take a music break and we're going to come back with the letter that was hand-delivered to Mr. Trump this week that declared America's sovereignty. Perhaps this is fitting.
Tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from
Detroit down to Houston, and New York to L.A., where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
in the land of cotton. Old times are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Sing it, fellas. Dixieland, I was born. Early, Lord, one frosty morn. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Thank you. You're fantastic. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Hi all and welcome back. Right. To All American Songs there. And in case people have doubts, I know our members don't. But this will probably go out to a wider field. Isn't this another Brit trashing the American history? No, it's not. I love this country and I love its people, and I've done, I think, more than enough to justify saying the truth here. It was difficult in the beginning. You're kind of rewriting history. But in essence, every country has to rewrite its history, as every country is being lied to. It just happens to be worse here than anywhere else. So I am committed to this country. And in essence, it's kind of ironic that it's a Brit that's exposing it. My former home country, you know. But the truth had to be told. Enough of the lies. So what happened this week? Right, we've been preparing this, or the team has, over a period of time where contracts had to end or be ended to then be able to take control of and then change the ways things have happened, not only in this country but globally. And the Manor World Holding Trust is kind of the enforcement of that in many ways. And we delivered by hand to President Donald J. Trump on Saturday, the 27th of January, 2018, the following declaration. Manor World Holding Trust recognizes the expiration of the treaty agreements between various aliases the trust has had in the past, such as Unknown Country or the Crown, etc. Further, the trust declares, as of the expiration of said treaties, the United States of America is a sovereignty unto itself, with no infringement on its sovereignty rights by any other nation, to include but not limited to Manor World Holding Trust, all of its former aliases, like the Crown, the Trust's former trustees, custodians, corporations and comptrollers. Full sovereign rights include, but not limited to, the right to sovereign territory, mineral rights, to hold and operate embassies, to hold and operate central banks, to hold and operate military and intelligence forces without any other foreign sovereign monarch influences. Further, the trust recognizes the United States of America as an equal sovereign entity. Shall it desire to enter into any further treaty to include the return of any of its property or properties which is currently held by separate treaty, both parties recognize each other to be a sovereign entity unto themselves, with no obligation except to its citizens. Manor World Holding Trust formally relinquishes all rights, property deeds, and custodianship to the property within the United States, known as the District of Columbia, also known as Washington, D.C., and any and all governing bodies contained therein, formally governed by the prior liaisons, trustees, and custodians of Manor World Holding Trust since 1864. Manat World Holding Trust formally acknowledges its agreements with the corporation formed in 1912, known as the Federal Reserve, signed as an infinite agreement under international corporate law. This term is 99 years. Therefore, the expiration of the funding agreement between the Manat World Holding Trust, be it by any other name, expired on June 15, 2011. Further, its service agreement with the United States of America expired on June 15, 2012. Manat World Holding Trust confirms the corporation known as the Federal Reserve is a corporation owned wholly by the Manat World Holding Trust, and Manat World Holding Trust, as of this day, shall transfer all ownership rights fully to the United States of America, to include its right to print paper currency, any and all future income, and any past income earned as of the 15th of June 2012. Any and all debts owed to it by the United States and any and all real property owned by the corporation will also be handed over. Manat World Holding Trust agrees to work together with you or your appointed representation to return any other property or properties the trust may hold on behalf of the United States, to include any dividends now due against any assets it may have pledged in the past. Please be advised, Manat World Holding Trust consolidation assets and restructuring began on the 5th of September 2012 and was completed on the 1st of February 2016. And as of the 28th of September 2012, I am the sole custodian, trustee, principal, decision-making party and owner, and this can be verified through any intelligence reference report reference in the above listed country code, any form of trustee from any nation to include but not limited to China, the UK and the USA. I've held no power over the trust since 2012, when they were relieved of duties due to multiple breaches of contract. Any other nation, society, order or organisation does not influence my sole decision making capacities in any way, nor do I have any superiors. I am not a member of any forementioned organisations. I act completely of my own recognizance. This document is valid as a treaty between both sovereigns and is legally binding under international law from this day forward, signed and acknowledged on the 27th day of January 2018. That was done by the trustee, the custodian, known as Miss Manor. And I will play a piece for her shortly, because that single stroke of a pen has ended all the nonsense of what I mentioned in the first part. It cuts off the trust. Was part of the Crown and part of the Federal Reserve, was all part of it. It all got wrapped up into one giant mess, to be quite honest, of thievery. And what the Trust have done is taken charge of that and released America from its former colony holders, known as the Crown, and declared it a sovereign nation. There's nothing to sign off on, it's already done. With that letter, that was a declaration, we are now sovereign. So there's no signing off or endorsing to be done. It's been delivered. And what has to take place is it has to be implemented. That's all. So we have an American government now. We can, let me just go through the list. So there'll be no infringements on its sovereign rights, which means we're not at the behest of any other country, be it the Crown, the Vatican, or anybody else. We retain all sovereign territory. So again, that doesn't belong to the trust, or it doesn't belong to Rothschilds or the Crown or anybody else. All mineral rights, which Hillary Clinton was about to sign off to the United Nations in September of last year, all of them, is now belonging to America. The right to hold and operate central banks. This means that the Federal Reserve is now shut down. And we can now set up the repurpose the Federal Reserve, whichever is the best way forward, our own central bank, American bank, not Federal Reserve, British Crown, Vatican, IMF and all that nonsense. We will have the right to hold and operate military and intelligence forces. This may come as a surprise to some, but we don't have a military or intelligence forces. They are operated by foreign agents. The military by the Jesuits, and the intelligence forces by the Crown, the Rothschilds, and all the other faction pieces which you've covered in previous shows. And so we can go ahead and do all that without any interference from any other sovereign or monarch. None whatsoever. The trust is now an equal sovereign with America and also the Kingdom of Manor. And there will be further treaties should the American government wish to do so. Where are we next? The District of Columbia, which was owned by the trust and, of course, the Chinese elders, the Rothschilds, et al. And the Crown, all think they own the trust. They don't. Not no more. These people have held that world trust over many hundreds of years and never once gave any money for the benefit of the people. Not once. China was in control around the 1500s and gave $20 million in 1520 to set up the Rothschild Empire. And what did the Rothschilds do? Nothing for the benefit of the people, clearly. So the District of Columbia, which was created as a separate principality, which operates outside of American, which is actually British law, and pays no taxes, has now been retained by the trust back to the America, the country, and its people. All of it, including the Capitol buildings, etc., which at times in American history, some of them major buildings have been pledged, like debt instruments, that is now being declared null and void. Well, like I said, the Federal Reserve is no longer have the right to print money. So we don't need Federal Reserve notes, which is a debt instrument. We have assets now for the first time. All those things that have been returned will now go into the asset column. And so now, under the agreement with the Federal Reserve, now defunct and expired, we being America, now have the right to print its own currency. Not Federal Reserve note. And whether that's the American dollar, it certainly won't be the Treasury Reserve note. Again, that's just a substitute of the last nonsense. Or a silver certificate. It may be various things. But it will change. Any and all future income will all go to America and not to the Crown. And any past income earned between the 15th of June 2012 or any debts owed to it will be returned via the trust. And any and all real property that was owned by the corporation known as the Federal Reserve will also be returned to the country. Oops. I think that's kind of covered it. I'll go into more details of what are the implications after this music piece, but the team have done fantastic to get this together and deliver it. Like I said, it doesn't need signing off. Trump doesn't have to sign anything. It's all done. What it needs to be is implemented. Well, these people have been working since at least 2007 when the World Trust was started to be cut off from the rogue elites and cabal, the funding. This is why the world went into an economic crash in 2008, because they couldn't keep looting out of the World Trust. What will take place is now America is sovereign, and it's up to Trump to implement it, is all the debts will be wiped out, all the assets will be paid forward, and all the assets will be then put up as collateral, which will bring about a new American currency. I think Miss Manner, and I have a feeling she'll be on the show again soon to give more details. There's a lot more going on currently that can't be delivered at the moment. More progress and more promising things. Hopefully soon we'll be able to reveal them when they're done, when they're confirmed. Not more promises, but perhaps this next song is fitting. This is going out to Miss Manna, America and its people. Thank you.
looking like the way back home. Light that warm, no matter where it goes. We're off to find the hero of the day. What if they should hold us someone?
Hi all and welcome back. So, just to reiterate, America is now a sovereign nation, period. I know some will have doubts, because certain letters have been sent before. None of those people had the validity the World Trust carries, is why. In essence, the World Trust, like I said, it's been ran by rogue entities and cabal and elites. And for those who don't know, others that didn't come from here. That's a fact. Whether people like that or not. and they've used the funds that was supposedly to be for the benefit of all the people, but has been used to basically take over the world, all its resources, all its corporations, all its business, all its banking, all its governments, etc., etc., including the people. So a group of people who were part of that system, you'd have to be a part of that system to know about it, decided they'd had enough. That's why I keep mentioning about the line in the 100. Where are all the good people? The answer is there are none. It's up to us to create them. And so they decided they were not going to sit by and watch these clowns and psychopaths eliminate 90% of humanity just because they think they're more special than everybody else because they're a certain bloodline or born into a certain family or have DNA of Draco imbued into them. Nobody is better than anybody else on this planet, whether they like that fact or not. So they decided to take back the World Trust for the benefit of the people. Now, this is all about America, obviously, this show. But for those of you who haven't listened to our show regularly, the Kingdom of Mana, and more importantly, the Mana World Holding Trust, can declare all countries sovereign, providing they are willing to enter into the agreement. So it's up to Britain. It's up to China. We were speaking to 122 nations, the last count I heard, who were interested in being declared sovereign. A sovereign has many implications. I've covered some of them. The banking. We can now have our own national bank. American bank. That's not Rothschilds. Or it's not part of the crown. It's a bank for and by the people. Washington DC no longer would come under special law or rules or statutes or regulations or maritime law or any of that nonsense. Providing it's delivered properly, the British law ends. So that's all the bar lawyers needing to get new licenses. Because we would go back to common or natural law. Laws made by or per the Constitution or American law. So that has big implications. The Constitution, should it be implemented, will return. The organic, original, proper Constitution. Not the ones looking like a constitution, but are actually not. So, in essence, this is freedom. But it's up to the people to deliver it. Now, the mineral rights, like I said, Hillary Clinton had signed over all American resources, now and the future, over to the UN and also to Russia, uranium. Well, with her defeat in a one horse race election, that contract was voided. So now the mineral rights and the benefits of and the profits of go to America, the country, and its people. The Federal Reserve has no more right to print Federal Reserve notes. It's my understanding they haven't printed any since 2009. Maybe you should get a full clarification on that. But should it be implemented, we will need a new currency. And not Treasury Reserve Note either. Proper American dollar. Or whatever they choose to call it. The IRS, given it's a collection arm of the Federal Reserve and also a foreign agent, should also be shut down with it. This has implications for us all, be it the taxes. They may choose to repurpose it, but given the country has largely got by, although it has increased debts recently, which has been cancelled anyway. A lot of those debts were for black budget expenditures by the same clowns who are trying to crash and burn not only this country but the whole world. We don't need those black budgets going forward. And with the, you could actually drop the income tax altogether. Because we've got by without it for, 84 years. Or you could lower it to something minimal, like 5%. So there's plenty of money even without the increased assets or the trust injected funds for projects that are waiting to roll out. Big projects are planned for this country. I'm aware of at least three of them. That's going to change things no end in this country. And hopefully in a future show we'll be able to release them. Trump hinted at it in the State of the Union speech. He also said something that was correct. We're going to give Washington DC back to its people. Now you know why. Because the military are not the American military and haven't been in our lifetime. Of course, under the Constitution, the bogus one, they're not allowed to engage on our soil. So if some country attacks us, they can't interfere. We've been left on our own for a long time. Now the military, should it be implemented quickly, now comes back under the control of the American government, the real one, not USA Inc., and its people. Now, the sovereignty issue, probably what will delay it for the public is sorting out the military. The military won't be happy at certain levels because as a sovereign you are not allowed to engage in war unless you are attacked. Well, given the fact that this country hasn't been attacked since World War II, yes, people might say 9/11, do more research. That's a lot of nonsense. It was all within the same clowns. Given the fact we've never been attacked, there's no necessity to think that suddenly every country is going to start attacking us. It's nonsense. So as a sovereign nation, war is cancelled. So if implemented, that means all our bases in foreign operations has to cease. You can't attack. That's the stipulation of being a sovereign nation. So this never-ending war on terror, which is actually a play on words, because terror is not T-E-R-R-O-R, it's actually war on terror, T-E-R-R-A, war on the world. So the military can now operate on our soil again. I would like to see each division of the military repurposed. The Air Force can clean up the mess that's in our skies, aka chemtrails, like blow them out of the sky. The Navy can clean up the oceans, the mess that they've created there, dumping nuclear waste and all kinds of other waste into the oceans. And the Army can clean up the land, starting in Iraq, after the damage we've done there, and Syria, and Afghanistan. And the engineers can come back here and fix the bridges, 80,000 of which are at a point of collapse in this country. So the military can still keep its budget. It just operates as a defensive force, not a let's goose step and attack every other country around the world because we want the resources on behalf of Rothschild et al. No. Back to the borders. So then we don't need to build a wall. We can employ the military to guard that wall or that region. So there's no loss of jobs, they just get repurposed with a different mindset. The debts of the country are raised. When you consider a lot of our money goes out, much of our GDP per year, on interest payments. This is to do with the 6% borrowing from the Federal Reserve, who already have our money. So with that debt erased, those interest payments are no longer required. That money that can then be spent on improving the people of this country. Making sure the 1 in 5 children who are currently living below the poverty line are fed. Removing the tens of thousands of homeless off our streets, improving the veterans' lives, which ultimately should go back to be under the banner of the military, in my opinion, part of their budget, as we're not fighting wars and needing 800 bases all around the world for no benefit to America. They can use some of those savings to look after the veterans properly. They're the ones that damage them. All the assets that belong to the country will be returned. All of them. So where certain ports or airports or bridges and roads were pledged to the trust, which then puts the rogue elements in control of them, all out. Them have been returned as per that declaration. So we've got everything back. That then becomes an asset, which then allows the country to print a certain amount of funds to operate in a better way. All the assets that were acquired on behalf of the World Trust should have come with dividends for the government. not debt. They declared it a debt and made them pay back their debts, not ours. And so all the dividends out of the World Trust will be given back to each country as they declared sovereign. That amounts to a huge amount of funds. So everything is there for America, the country, its government, its constitution, its freedom and its people to go forward in a better manner. So what will happen to the people? Well, clearly we will have more funds and a lot less austerity. I can't promise you they're going to eliminate income tax. That's for others to decide. Obviously, there'll be recommendations put forward. But it's also up to us if we realise, and many support this show, on what's stated within it. The public should demand that the income tax is cancelled, or at least lowered drastically. Because if you, even if you just tax it at 1 or 2%, it's 1 or 2% more taxes that the country wasn't getting to begin with. It still ends up a vast amount. So with all the assets returned and the fact that this country is not paying huge volumes of interest per year, there's going to be a lot more funds to improve people's lives. You know, I'm not going to make outlandish promises and you're going to get, including myself, your homes back. I don't know how that will play out. There may be some provision. But we also need to take stock, is that freedom is not about bundles of money. It's that greed that's caused all this. And yes, each and every one of us are owed multi-millions. And I mean multi-millions. With the birth certificate scandal, the fact that we were put up as chattel property, as collateral in 1934, which meant they became our parents, and parents pay for the child. They should have paid every single utility bill. Can they pay that back? No. All our income tax was illegal. Can they pay that back? No. So we have to not go overboard with demands. Otherwise, everyone ends up with 100 million, and what's the point of it? We have to lower our expectations and needs of money. I'd like to see businesses start up where there's a cap on how much you can earn. You know, that clown in Ocwen that took my house this week, he's earning $4.2 million a year. I don't believe personally people should earn over $100,000. Why do you need $100,000 a year? So you can go back and buy fancy cars and show off to your mates. Is that what we're all about? Showing off what we've got? Espousing how wealthy we are? Is that a symbol of success? No. That's a symbol of their success that they've pushed onto the people. And what we need is to lower that need to show off and buy bigger houses and better houses and compete with friends, family and neighbours, because that is what's killed us. You can't get by on 100,000. The problem is you. not the system. The problem is you're overspending on stuff you don't really need, and it's more about impressing other people. Well, let's stop impressing other people with bundles of money. As well, there's so many on 100,000 a year, there's also loads of people who are on less than 10, suffering. So all that bragging and showing off and competing comes at a cost to other people who have nothing. And I hope as we go forward, we all take that on board. If we're going to go forward and be a new country again with new ways and better ways, we have to go forward with a better mindset than we have currently of what's in it for me. Now, what's in it for us all? If you are setting up a company to earn vast amounts of money, you're setting it up in the wrong way. If that's your driving goal, to have bundles of money, you are operating in the wrong way. Because if everyone has bundles of money, there's always someone who loses. So let's all have a moderate amount to fulfill what is the basic needs in life. Food, clean water, and not plastic GMO food. Clean air. Clothes on our back. Not with fancy stupid names of Nike and all that nonsense. They're no better as commodities than the cheaper versions. But you have to go along with the crowd. No, you don't. Again, that's a corporate market employ to pull you in to buy a dearer item, which then puts you in more debt. We need to think better. Basic needs in life. You know, many of us in America already have the basics. There's vast quantities of people, 40 to 60% of the people, who don't. No roof over their head, no electricity, no phones, no internet. Nothing. Dipping out of muddy water filled with parasites, because that's all they've got to drink. That has to stop. And it requires a change of mindset by the military, by the government, and by the people. Basic, an abundance of the basic needs in life, not abundance to go and buy fancy gadgets. All the distraction from who and what you are, really. And we've all done it. I've done it myself. Gone for the big house, and it ended up a millstone around my neck. Who did it impress? Well, about 6 to 8 people that came over from the UK every year. But after they'd gone, you're still paying the bill. Is it really worth that 2 weeks of, oh my God, this is fantastic? No, it's not. Maybe it's time we didn't get what we want, but we got what we need. And hopefully going forward, and this is implemented in a smooth and speedy way. Certain things will not happen overnight. They can't do. You can't just change everything overnight, even if it's the banking. Things have to be put in place. but the fact that they've had all their assets taken off them and the debts declared back to them is a big oops. And it's not on the people. So I hope that clears a lot of things up. There's nothing, I'll repeat again, there's nothing to sign off. It's already done, declared, and valid. What it needs now is people to go forward with it. We can play our role in the alternative media by getting this information out so that no one's under the illusion we're fighting for this, that, and the other when it's already done. We just need those in office to implement it, and quickly. The IRS, you know, a lot of people will have parties when they go down, but it has to be done in a manner of phasing in, phasing out. Whilst we all would love the IRS to be shut down tomorrow and you're not paying any taxes for the rest of the year or any other year, what you've got to take into consideration, there's a lot of people employed via the IRS. Think of all the jobs the accountants would lose. So something has to be put in its place. But there's no need to collect that amount of taxes that they have been doing, because most of it has been going on interest payments and paying the Federal Reserve, which we'd no longer need to do with our own central bank. So maybe the IRS gets repurposed. You know, time will tell on everything. But once it goes viral, everything that's been stated in this show is the truth, then it's up to the people to go, we've had enough of this, we want it delivered, and delivered now. So I hope you've enjoyed this follow-up. I hope I've clarified as much as I can and answered all your queries. I'm just checking on the Facebook. Yeah. So I hope that clears everything up. You have better understanding of it. We're there, but we just need certain clowns, as I call them, to get started. And let's get this country back on its feet. And then I hope it then gives, what it will do, is give the courage to Canada to then come and work with us, and we will draft up the paperwork to declare Canada sovereign also. Australia, another colony country. India, another colony country. New Zealand. You don't have to remain under British, Dutch, or any other control anymore. You can have a country of your own. So, on that positive note, what I will say from that took place, there's been a lot of meetings taking place today. The military know. The government people know. The lawmakers know. And we've gained a certain amount of traction with certain top brass of the military today. They're the ones that can speed it through. Right, okay. That's enough for tonight. I hope you've enjoyed the show. More details will follow. There are certain things that are in progress at the moment that can't be outed. Very positive things. And we will continue with this. What I did say last year, it wouldn't be a light switch moment. It may be a light switch moment for America, but there'll be a series of events that will take place, and eventually people will go, ah, that's what that was about. And we all come to the realization we've all been free for a while and we're all still sitting there waiting. What do we do next? Well, what you do next is what I've been telling you. if you're asking what next, you haven't been listening properly to the show, have you? So I'm going to give you more things to ponder. What you do next is you think of the future. How would you like do it in two phases? Your personal life to go, where would you like to work? Because jobs will change. A lot of jobs in government will go because they're unnecessary and unconstitutional. So new jobs will come forward. In fact, there'll be a creation of at least 5 million jobs, maybe quadruple that once the project starts. The manufacturing is returning here. There'll be a lot more manufacturing once the project starts, and that will be done in America. So what would you like your life to go forward with, and what would you like for the collective? This is why I keep telling you, what happens next? What happens next? So it clues you into what you would like to see. By doing that, you are manifesting reality. You are creating the future, and if enough create the same future, it does and will manifest. Right, where are we going to end on? Yeah, let's have this. This has been a special show of the Truth, Honor and Integrity. I hope you've all enjoyed it. For those of you who don't normally listen to our show, we are on the Spreaker, on the Truth, Honor and Integrity every Thursday at 7:30. And so come and join us. We have intel most weeks. We'll probably have more going forward. And we have a lot of op-ed pieces and news and some different things at different times. And a bit of fun as well. So, hope you enjoyed the show. My name's Thomas Williams. Bye for now. It's time to roll with the changes.